Hey, Janina here. So today we are in Ed's Shangri-La Hotel, and my voice is kind of low because I'm like in the lobby area and I don't want to attract too much attention. But today I'm interviewing Charlie. Who is what?
So just a quick OTD for you guys. I'm wearing this black dress that I got from Forever 21. It was in my haul. So was my jacket, and I'm wearing my black Sperry's that are my favorite. Do I ever wear anything else lately? No, I don't.
I have my cards. And we're about to go live at the Zara. Wow, you're tall.
I'll sit down.
I'm sorry about. Oh wait, sorry. I have my questions.
I just have giant tarantula legs.
Oh, that's great. That's amazing.
That's all you look for, man.
Yeah, you know, that's like, oh my gosh, I wish my future husband will have giant tarantula legs.
Look no further. Here I am.
Okay, so I have the hardest question in the world. Mm-hmm. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Bad breath or body odor?
That's
like if you had to live with one thing forever.
No body odor, can't do that. I won't talk. I won't talk anymore.
Okay.
Cause I can't have BO.
Okay.
I haven't not smelled good since 7th grade.
Wow.
Yeah.
That must be a great talent.
I've smelled great all the time.
Mm. What is your go-to midnight snack food?
Oreo cookies. Because it says vegan, and that in my mind means I can eat the whole bag.
Oh.
Cause it's healthy.
I love your logic.
Thank you.
I heard you have the greatest nickname in the world.
Chunky Spunky Monkey?
Mm-hmm. Where did that come from?
My friend Mike. Hello, Mike. My friend Mike made that for me in college when he just said that I was spunky.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
A little more like serious questions.
Okay.
So game face back on.
Okay.
Did you ever think that you'd like become this big and travel the world? I mean, you came from like New Jersey.
Yeah, no, I was totally happy with being a record producer. I kind of always knew that I was going to have a hit song, but that's just because of the hard work. I never thought it was actually going to translate to having a full-on artist career, but I'm super happy about that.
Well, that's great.
Yeah.
What is your funniest or weirdest fan experience?
Oh, good question. I had a lot of them. I think I was in a hotel one time and there was like a decorative ladder. And they climbed up the ladder and tapped on my window.
Wow.
On the 15th floor.
Are you an introvert or an extrovert?
I'm a bit of both. Mm-hmm. I can be very extroverted, and then when I'm not comfortable, I'm very introverted.
Okay, so how did you overcome that? And what's your advice to anybody who wants to start music?
I overcame that through music.
Oh, okay.
Just by like uploading my stuff on YouTube, getting confidence, swagger points.
Nice.
You always have to quietly feel yourself. You always have to like quietly kind of be a little arrogant in your head. But yeah, but like you don't want to like, you know, make people upset, but like just be confident in your head. And that's exactly what happened. And then when I got fans, it kind of grew into more.
Mm-hmm. Can you just say a quick message to anybody or to my viewers and your fans and everybody?
Hi, her viewers. Isn't she awesome? Isn't she lovely? And she's having me, Shawn Mendes, on her program right now.
Wow.
That's a great
show. Shawn Mendes looks a bit different now.
I think Shawn looks not like me, but I don't know why I keep saying that joke. Hi, her viewers. So thank you for having me.
Well, thank you for being on my channel. We can say goodbye.
Well, that just happened. I don't really know. I'm like, it's like, what? I can't talk. Well, I wasn't nervous, but it was really fun. He's really fun. All of you guys were like super energetic on the Facebook live chat. So if you want to watch that interview pala, like the whole interview, you can go to Warner Music Philippines and the live interview is there. But then probably when you watch this, it won't be live anymore, obviously. But yeah, that I will talk to you when I can talk normally. Okay, bye. Okay, so we're here right in front of the Kia Theater because I wasn't supposed to watch because I wasn't able to grab tickets before they were sold out. And then Charlie found out and then he was like, oh no, that won't work. So he got me a ticket in the orchestra section and I'm like, okay then, we do that. Thanks, Charlie.
Yeah.
Guess who's back? Back again. Woo! I just got home. Okay, let's move. Am I in the middle? Oh, I look like a bald man. I'm so sorry. So right now is hashtag Jenny Inspiration time. It's kind of like a new name for this usual segment that I have that a viewer actually suggested, but I forgot your username. I'm so sorry, but please comment down below. I'd really love to thank you because oh my gosh, I have a pun. Like, finally, I have a pun. It's the best day ever. Best day ever, yes. Yes, good segue, Janina. It was like one of the best days ever. First of all, I woke up today and I had like about 10 hours of sleep, and that's already amazing itself. But then I went to interview Charlie Puth. Yeah, when Warner Music emailed me last week, I couldn't believe it. I was so excited. And yes, they only emailed me last week means I didn't really have that much time to prepare, but it was okay because he was so warm and just welcoming, and he was funny and he was charming and he was cute, and oh my gosh, he was just so adorable. And oh yeah, and if you guys want to see like the full interview, it's there in Warner Music PH. It was actually on Facebook Live, so go check that out. Leave it a like or a nice comment, whatever floats your goat. Then, like what I was trying to say a while ago, I really wasn't planning on going tonight because I wasn't able to grab some tickets before the show went sold out. And then he found out that I wasn't going and he was like, oh, I'll fix that. But then, you know, people sometimes make promises that they don't intend to keep. Okay. And then I said goodbye and he was like, yeah, we gotta get her tickets and stuff. But then again, I kind of just shrugged it off because I've had experiences when people say things and it's just not, yeah. Anyway, so I was on my way home, I was in the car, and then Atenina from Warner Music PH called and she was like, Janina, we have a ticket for you. Gusto ka talagang niyang nandun. What? Gusto niya talagang nandun ka. Okay, Janina, Tagalog, you can do this. So of course, haba ng hair, diba? Well, ngayon naka-ponytail ako. Pero kanina, mahaba hair ko. Yeah, so I was able to get a ticket in Orchestra Center, and that was amazing because I was able to meet so much of my Vela fam there. I mean, like, whoa. It was a lot of Vela fam. I mean, I'm looking at all your tweets now and I'm like, wow. It was so amazing to see so much of my Vela fam in like one place. So sorry. And then about his performance, this is where the kind of Jenny inspiration comes in. I thought it was just so amazing because the whole show wasn't like super extravagant or flashy, because you could see that he was really there and his heart was to really share his music. And you could feel in like every note that he sang and every key that he pressed or played, like you could feel that he felt it, and you could feel like this is what he loves to do. And I thought that was really amazing because he wasn't just like a performer and artist, he was like really a musician, and he was somebody who was really passionate about music. And yeah, it was just a really nice reminder to me that always remember why you're doing what you're doing, and make sure that it's not for the fame or for the money, but because it's really your passion. It's really because that's what you love to do. And that goes for like him, music, and that goes for sports. And if you want to start a YouTube channel, it goes like it's so important in YouTube that you do it not because you want your views to go up or because you want a lot of likes, but because it's really your passion. If beauty is your passion, then go. If fashion is your passion, then go. Sports, vlogging, sharing your life, if that's your passion, then go. But then if you want to do this to earn money or to get famous or to get fame or to be a star, I'm just saying, maybe in the end that won't super work out for you. What am I saying? Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed that video. Please give it a thumbs up if you did. Don't forget to leave a nice comment below because I love reading your comments. And if you're new to my channel, hey, what's up? Hello, see ya pretty. I don't swear on my channel and in real life. Anyway, if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe because when you subscribe, you get notified every time I post a new video. So don't forget to do that. I will see you guys later and may the wings of your eyeliner always be even.